Hi everyone, in this video we'll see a modern Linux installation. There are many Linux distro, but in this video I recommend three Linux distributions for different reasons. And in particular, the most important part of this video is the components that I will use. The first one is systemd boot, which is a new bootloader that not every Linux distro adopt yet. And the other important component is LUKS for hard drive encryption. And in particular, we will use the most secure version, which is LUKS2, which isn't yet adopted by all the Linux distributions. As I said in this video, I recommend some Linux distribution, but not every Linux distribution is easy to do this setup. And so I chose OpenSUSE MicroOS, which is, in my opinion, the easiest trade-off to have a secure and maintainable Linux distro. And in particular, this Linux distribution is also immutable, so you can roll back to a previous installation if something goes bad. So the distro, the ISO that I will use is this one, x86-64 bits, but as you can see there are also different architecture. So let's start with the installation. You have to put this ISO file with the Balena Etcher on a USB key or a CD-ROM, a DVD. And this is the boot process. So we have installation or boot from hard disk, and I choose installation. We don't have a live CD here. We have to do the installation to see and to try the Linux distro. Hardware detection. Okay, we can start with the installer. Okay, here you can pick your language, your keyboard, and you can test your keyboard here. And I agree. Next. Okay, this is the important part. We have several flavors of this Linux distro, and I will pick MicroOS Desktop GNOME, which is also named Aeon. So in future probably you will see a different name. You can also choose KDE if you prefer a different desktop environment, while the other option do not have a desktop, so are more useful in a server installation. So MicroOS with GNOME. Next. Okay, I choose the default server. This is the password for the root user. And again, okay, they say that my password is too simple, but it's okay for this demo. This is the installation detail, and we will do some changes here. So see details, and also in bootloader. So booting, I change the bootloader from GRUB2 to systemd boot. Okay. And also in partitioning, I do guided setup. Okay. And here I enable encryption without LVM because I don't care. And again, the password. This is a different password. This is the password for the disks, and the other was the password for the root user. Okay, again, is too simple. And this is the file system, and I will leave with the BTRFS. Okay, accept. Let's check again the report. So here we have the partitions, the desktop environment, and this is the bootloader, which I try again. I want systemdboot. Okay, systemdboot, and it seems fine. So install, I confirm. Okay, if I continue, it will wipe my partitions. So install here. Almost done. Okay. This is also important because I do not want to reboot now. And let's see if I can go to terminal. Okay, ls blk. Okay, I think vda2 is the one. Okay, I have a crypt setup, convert dev vda2 type LUKS2. Here I type yes, and I hope that it will work because by default the installer use LUKS1 and I want LUKS2. Okay, I can do it from here. So you have to do this command if you want LUKS2 from live DVD, but with this command you will convert this partition to LUKS2 without any problems. Okay, so reboot. Okay, we have the bootloader, which is systemd systemd boot, and here when you have different updates you will see the history, so you can roll back to a previous configuration of your root system, not your home but your system installation. But the installation isn't finished yet because now we have to initialize the first user. Here maybe it isn't very evident, but you need to type the LUKS password for the hard disk. Okay, so the boot will continue. Okay, we can continue the installation. So again the language, again the keyboard, and if you want to enable location services for the geolocalization, and here we can pick a city, online accounts, and the default user that you will use normally, password. Okay, next. And we can start using OpenSUSE microOS with these fixes. Okay, this is the Flatpak initialization, because in this distro you have installed by default Flatpak for user application, but also DistroBox for applications that aren't supported by Flatpak packages. And as you can see, the installation is very empty. So we have just settings and system monitor in the available applications, and software and the file manager. So in the meanwhile, we can check the version, which is the latest GNOME version here. And as you can see, GNOME 45 with Wayland and one of the latest kernels. Under disk, we can see that we have the LUKS encryption enabled, but it's still version 1. So if you want really LUKS2, you have to type those commands in a rescue boot mode if you want to convert this LUKS1 partition in LUKS2, and it is a very fast process, so you just have to do it from the rescue mode, not the running system. Okay, let's try the software. Okay, that's it. This is OpenSUSE MicroOS with systemd boot and LUKS2. I think this is a very maintainable Linux system because you will get the automatic updates without any issues. I hope you found this video useful, and see you in another one. Bye.